When I was a kid, I had to walk 3 miles each way to school. The snowdrifts were 7 feet high, and I had no shoes. Gee, Granddad, that's nothing. Today I had to go to Paris for my French class, MIT for computer science, and the New York Stock Exchange for economics. Welcome to the world of distant learning. What do we know? What is the definition of distance education? It's institution-based formal education where the learning group is separated and where interactive telecommunication systems and media are used to connect learners, resources, and instructors. Four main components comprise this definition. First is the concept that distance education is institutionally based. This is what differentiates distance education from self-study. Whereas the institution referred to in this definition could be a traditional educational school or college or non-traditional institutions that offer education to students at a distance are increasingly emerging. Businesses, companies, and corporations are offering instruction at a distance. The second component of the definition of distance education is the concept of separation of the teacher and student. Most often, separation is thought of in geographic terms. Teachers are in one location and the students are in another. Also implied by the definition is the separation of teachers and students in time. Asynchronous distance education means that instruction is offered and students access it at separate times or any time it is convenient to them. Finally, intellectual separation of teachers and students is important. Obviously, teachers have an understanding of the concepts presented in the course that students do not possess. In this case, the reduction of separation is a goal of the distance education system. Interactive telecommunications is a third component of the definition of distance education. Interaction can be synchronous or asynchronous, at the same time or at different times. Interaction is critical, but not at the expense of content. In other words, it is important that learners be able to interact with each other with resources of instruction and with their teacher. However, interaction should not be the primary characteristic of instruction, but should be available, commonplace, and relevant. The phrase telecommunication systems implies electronic media such as television, telephone, and the internet. But this term need not be limited to only electronic media. Telecommunications is defined as communicating at a distance. And finally, we examine the concept of connecting learners, resources, and instructors. This means that there are instructors who interact with learners and that resources are available that permit learning to occur. Resources should be subjected to instructional design procedures that organize them into learning experiences that promote learning, including resources that can be observed, felt, heard, or completed. Distance learning and distance teaching equals distance education. Although comparison research studies on achievement tend to show no significant difference between different delivery systems and between distance online education and traditional education, several recent studies indicate a significantly higher achievement level for those learning at a distance. This is a complex issue that warrants further investigation. The effect of technology on student learning has affected the manner in which students want to learn. There are conflicting pressures on distance educators. Students prefer to learn in a classroom, but demand to be permitted to learn at a distance. However, the best current evidence is that media are mere vehicles that deliver instruction but do not influence student achievement any more than the truck that delivers our groceries causes changes in our nutrition. What is the equivalency theory of distance education? Learners, distant and local, should be provided equivalent learning experiences in order for them to achieve similar learning outcomes. It is in this environment of virtual education that the equivalency theory of distance education has emerged. Some advocates of distant education have mistakenly tried to provide identical instructional situations for all students, no matter when or where they learn. In other words, equivalent rather than identical learning experiences should be provided to each learner, whether local or distant, and the expectation should be that equivalent outcomes, rather than identical, should be expected of each learner. Thus, each learner might access different, unequal, yet equivalent instructional strategies, varying instructional resources, or individually prescribed activities that are different from what is prescribed to other students. If this distance education course is effectively designed and equivalent experiences are available, then potential learners will reach the course's instructional objectives. The experiences of the local learner and the distant learner should be equivalent value, even though these experiences might be quite different.